this episode, we're going to look at some of the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines. And for those who don't know what this is, it is basically a set of guidelines that you are able to follow in order to make your website more accessible. And off the bat, you may not think that this is applicable to you. However, I think few of us developers are in a situation where we are affected to such a degree. And as a consequence, I think accessibility almost becomes an afterthought. That is, of course, unless if you are developing a website specifically targeting individuals where it may be necessary. And so, within this episode, we're going to look at a few different things about website accessibility, as well as some tools or cheat sheets that might be helpful when developing your application. And in general, it is important that the web be accessible to everyone in order to provide equal access and equal opportunity to people with disabilities. And in a lot of cases, your website might already be most of the way there. You might be missing just a few different key elements, which may not seem a big difference to you, but to someone with a disability who's using screen readers or other utilities, it can make a very big difference for them. So to start off with a Rails 6 application, I'm going to use Bootstrap just so we can get some of the different kind of content that we would see in normal websites like Modal's. And so I'm going to start with a yarn, add Bootstrap. But the latest version of Bootstrap, at the time of this recording, it is 4.3.1. We also are still reliant on jQuery. So I'll also add in jQuery. And then we also need the popper.js. To watch this full episode and more videos, visit driftandruby.com and subscribe to the Pro Membership.